This question, I'm going to ask the non-chairman commissioners a series of what I hope are quick questions in expectation, hopefully, of an equally quick answer. Ms. Svinicki, is the chairman's behavior affecting your ability to discharge the duties for which you took an oath to discharge?
To this point, I believe that I have had access to what I need to faithfully execute my duties. However, I'm concerned that we're at the point where that is being compromised.
Have you lost confidence in his ability to lead?
Yes, on the basis of his interpersonal conduct, I have.
Commissioner Magwood, same two questions to you. Do you believe his behavior is impacting your ability to do your job, and have you lost confidence in his ability to lead?
It's a very complicated question. It's hard to answer the yes and no. Let me answer it this way. I think that over the time that I've been a commissioner, I've been able to get information that it gives me enough confidence to make votes and to make decisions. There have been times when getting the information has been more difficult than I think it should have been. My biggest concern is there always is the chance that there's some piece of information I just didn't even know existed that never got to me. So as far as I know, I've had the ability to make decisions fully informed. I have questions, I have doubts, and I have concerns.
Commissioner Ostendorf.
My concerns with respect to the chairman's style have been primarily that his interface with our NRC staff has been abrasive. He uses the term passionate. I would say it has prevented staff from feeling comfortable they can bring forth their best views and recommendations to the Commission. From that standpoint, I think that's a grave concern.
Have you lost confidence in his ability to lead?
At this stage, I have, yes.
Commissioner Ospitalakis?
So far, my votes have been have not been affected adversely by any actions by the chairman. And in fact, in the letter to the chief of staff, we said that there may be some harm in the future if this continues. I believe if the chairman lets the staff send us their true views when various issues come before the Commission, and if he also controls his temper a little bit, he can continue to lead the Commission.
Chairman, there was an apology issued. I don't know whether you drafted it or the White House drafted it. Who drafted your apology?
I prepared a letter that I sent to Mr. Daley. I'm not sure if that's the letter you're referring to.
Have you apologized more than once?
I have indicated to Mr. Daley in that letter that I was sorry for the distraction that this has caused.
Is that the only thing you're sorry for, is the distraction? Do you admit any of the conduct that's been alleged this morning?
If, again, many of these accusations I'm hearing for the first time.
Well, that doesn't impact whether they're true or not. The fact that you haven't heard them yet doesn't mean they're not true. My question is simple. Are they true?
I don't believe that they are true.
What does that mean, I don't believe that they are true? Have you been verbally abusive to female staff?
No, I have not.
Have you withheld information from your fellow commissioner?
I have not.
Have you asked anyone, are they on your team?
I have never said something like that.
Chairman, let me tell you what it looks like from my vantage point, which my background is not in nuclear science. When you have four eyewitnesses that testify to something under oath, you know what they call the defendant after that? An inmate. Four eyewitnesses to the conduct. It is unprecedented to me to have colleagues criticize one another privately. To do it publicly and to have to sit on either side of you to do it before a committee of Congress, to me, is unprecedented. None of the allegations they have made are accurate. Is that your testimony?
I believe that many of these instances that they are referring to have been misconstrued, and as I have indicated, that there are issues where I think we can improve our communication.
So what did you apologize for?
I apologize, as I indicated,
for their misunderstanding. Did you apologize because they misunderstood what you did?
I have offered to my colleagues that we sit down with a third party, someone that we all could agree on to
talk about
these
issues.
We really
need a counselor for the Nuclear Regulatory Commission. We need a counselor for that.
I am very interested in improving the communication because I think it is
vital. Does it matter to you that the four of them either have or are rapidly losing confidence in your leadership? Does that matter to you?
That is very important to me, and it is something that I am very interested in working on.
But you deny the allegations that they testified to under oath?
Congressman, I believe I have answered this question.
Well, do it again for me. You deny them?
As I said, I believe I've answered this question very, very well to the best of my ability here.
Would recognize.